Hey guys, welcome to vtchacademy.com. And today's topic is trigonometric ratios of negative angles. So first, let me explain what is a positive angle and what will be the negative angle. So if the angle theta, that is 0 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to 2 pi, is measured in anti-clockwise direction starting from the initial side Ox, then it is defined as positive angle. And if the same angle theta is measured in clockwise direction, then it is defined as negative angle, and it is identified with minus theta. And now let me explain this concept using a rough diagram over here. So here we have a coordinate plane where this is the y-axis and this is x-axis. And here we get the origin, and it is named negative x-axis as x dash and negative y-axis as y dash. Let us assume a ray which makes an angle theta in anticlockwise direction. So here this will be the positive angle. And now let us say the same angle theta when measured in clockwise direction. So here we get the ray which makes the same angle theta in clockwise direction. So hence we get the negative angle. So here we get minus theta. And then we can also write the value of minus theta as 2 pi minus theta, because we already know that a complete angle makes 360 degrees. So from 360 degrees we can subtract this negative angle. So we get the value of negative angle, that is minus theta. And now let us discuss trigonometric ratios of negative angle. So first let us begin with sine minus theta. So here we can write sine minus theta as sine 2 pi minus theta, as the value of minus theta and also the value of 2 pi minus theta will be same. So we already know that sine 360 minus theta. So 360 minus theta lies in fourth quadrant. So we get the result in negative. And 360 is an even number, so sine remains sine. So here we get sine 360 minus theta, which is equal to minus sine theta. So by using this concept here, we get the result of sine 2 pi minus theta as minus sine theta. And here we can also find the same value of sine minus theta by using the definition of sine theta. So for using the definition, we need the opposite side and the hypotenuse side. So let us draw a projection from x-axis to the ray, which will be at the distance of minus y units. And let us name the hypotenuse, that is this ray, as r. And then in the quadrant 1, we will have the same projection from x-axis to this ray, which will be at y units from x-axis. And then let us name this hypotenuse as r. So we already know the definition of sine theta, which is opposite side by hypotenuse side. So in order to find the value of sine minus theta, the side opposite to the angle, which is minus theta, we get here minus y as the opposite side. So minus y divided by the hypotenuse side, which is r here. So we get minus y by r, and y by r is the definition of sine theta. So that implies we get here minus of the definition of sine theta. So we get minus of sine theta as the value of sine minus theta. So from both the equations 1 and 2, we can say that sine minus theta is equal to minus sine theta. And now let us find the value for cos minus theta. So we can also write cos minus theta is in the form of cos 2 pi minus theta, as the value of 2 pi minus theta will be equal to the value of minus theta. So hence 360 minus theta lies in fourth quadrant, and in the fourth quadrant cos and its reciprocal secant are positive. So here we get the result in positive, and whereas 2 pi is an even number, so cos remains cos. So hence the value for cos 2 pi minus theta is equal to cos theta. And now let us name this equation as equation 3. And similarly, we can prove this by using the definition of cos theta. So cos theta will be given by the definition of adjacent side by hypotenuse side. So the side adjacent to minus theta is x. So here we get x by the hypotenuse side r. So here we get x by r as the definition of cos minus theta, which is also equal to the definition of cos theta. So let us name this as equation 4. And from both equation 1 and 2, we can say that cos minus theta is equal to cos theta. And then similarly, we get the values of all the trigonometric ratios as tan minus theta is equal to minus tan theta and cot minus theta is equal to minus cot theta. And then cosecant minus theta is equal to minus cosecant theta, whereas secant minus theta is equal to secant theta. So in short, the theta which measured in clockwise direction is the negative angle. And minus theta lies in fourth quadrant, and we already know that in fourth quadrant only cos and its reciprocal secant are positive. So the value for cos minus theta and secant minus theta will be positive, and the values for the rest of the trigonometric ratios of minus theta will be negative. And now let us proceed and discuss an example on this concept. So here we have to find the value for sine minus 405 degrees. So we already learned earlier that is sine minus theta is equal to minus sine theta. So here we get minus sine 405 degrees. This can be written as minus sine 360 degrees plus 45 degrees. And here it is in the form of 360 plus theta. So sine 360 plus theta is equal to sine theta. So here we get minus sine 45 degrees. So that implies the value for sine 45 is 1 by root 2. So here we get the result as minus 1 by root 2. So hence the value for sine minus 405 degrees is equal to minus 1 by root 2. And now let us find the value for secant minus of 2100 degrees. So we already discussed that secant minus theta is equal to secant theta. So here we get secant 2100 degrees. And now let us see how we can write this in the form of a trigonometric function. So in order to write, we already know that 6 into 360 degrees is 2160 degrees, and subtracting 60 degrees from 2160, we get 2100, which we want. So we can write secant 2100 degrees as secant 6 into 360 degrees minus 60 degrees. So here it is in the form of secant 360 minus theta, which is equal to secant theta. So here we get secant 60 degrees, and the value for secant 60 degrees is 2, as the value for cos 60 is 1 by 2. So we can say that secant 60 is equal to 2. So 2 is the value for secant minus of 2100 degrees. So this was a basic introduction on trigonometric ratios of negative angles. Hope you understood the concept. Do like and subscribe to vdchacademy.com. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.